Nutritional Recommendations. The nutritional recommendations are standardizations determined by appropriate groups of researchers, linked to political systems. In these we have the WHO and the DRI's. WHO, that means World Health Organization, is a group of research more managed to a global vision. Already the DRIs are groups of research more tied to the United States, and linked to an organizational political system tending to more specific to the region than WHO. What would be the best choice then? If you are part of a US society, then DRIs would be more ideal, but relative to other countries would be better than the WHO. But you should always look for a lack of information from a group, look for the data that exists. In them we have the recommendations for population and for individuals. For individuals, a representation of the necessity is used for 50% of a population, and the recommendations population is used a representation that contemplates 97.5% of a population. That is, if a population uses the population recommendation, what we have is that we are giving a recommendation that favors the obesity of this population. In other words, if a person looks at the population recommendation and tries to follow, it has 97.5% of being in factor to gain weight. In other words, it is usually above what one needs. So what to do? Does it mean that everyone is obliged to consult a nutritionist? So, would we have normal people do not know to feed? The answer would be for regional food expertise to be followed. Or, it is the cultural knowledge that formed this population and made it remain in that environment is the style that is idealized as correct for the group. But if people start to get food that was not in the crop, that is, new food, usually from other countries and artificially built, with different food values, then how would one use cultural knowledge if food is not part of the culture? And here's the problem, how can one know how much to eat if what you eat is passed through industrial functions, and ultra-processed foods? That is, in these cases a specialist is necessary because there are no cultural parameters proven by the decades to justify a type of regime with ultra-processed foods. What would be the best then? It would be best to feed on the best and natural food in the region in which it is inserted, and to be a genetically homogeneous individual in that region. In other words, to valorize the millenarian alimentary systems, with some improvements. In other words, industrialized-based food tends to be indeterminate of what is healthy and what is harmful.